Every once in a while, we find an object in the universe that completely mystifies us. For generations, astronomers have been observing distant galaxies present all throughout the universe, cataloguing them and noting their various characteristics. Overwhelmingly, galaxies fell into three different categories: spiral galaxies, where stars are concentrated in vast, sweeping arms; elliptical galaxies, where stars swarm around a central region; and irregular galaxies, which are neither spiral nor elliptical, and which often correspond to two or more galaxies in the process of interacting. Spirals and ellipticals are ubiquitous, with spirals more common among isolated or sparsely populated regions of space, while ellipticals often dominate the centers of large galaxy clusters. But in 1950, astronomer Arther Hoag discovered a galaxy unlike any other Hoag's object, dominated by a vast ring-like halo. 70 years later, we're still struggling to piece together this galactic mystery. When it was first discovered, astronomers only knew of a few ways to make a ring-like object in space, where a central, bright core appears surrounded by a luminous halo. Yet, none of them quite fit the bill when it came to Hoag's object. Planetary nebulae, like the Ring Nebula or the Helix Nebula, have either dying stars or stellar remnants at their cores with a bright halo surrounding them, but the central nucleus of Hoag's object is all wrong for that. The halo, rather than showing strong emission lines, instead indicates a population of young, blue stars. It's definitely galactic in nature.
He even suggested that it could be a gravitational lens, as those systems can produce a ring in the case of perfect alignments, but both the center and the halo display identical redshifts. They're part of the same system. Not caused by gravitational lensing, the cartwheel galaxy, shown above, is perhaps the most famous example of a ring galaxy produced by a collision. When a small galaxy collides with a larger one at high speeds, a shock wave propagates outwards from the center, causing gas to compress and triggering the formation of new stars at specific radii from the center. This density wave has to move quickly, on the order of 100 kilometers per second or more, in order to explain what we observe. In addition, that ionized hydrogen needs to stick around for a while, reverting to neutral hydrogen as the years go by millions at a time. That's how you create a typical classic ring galaxy. But in all of these cases, where the result is a classic ring galaxy, there are certain features that we can find that are conspicuously absent from Hoag's object. These include the identification of a second galaxy with a distinct population of stars from the main galaxy, the presence of faint fragments of a collision that should persist for billions of years, and a high relative velocity between multiple components of the system. This was all about today's video on Ring Galaxy. Thank you for watching.